Hello everyone, welcome to another video. This week I will be playing the ramp deck that Jake Mondello took to top 8 in GP Quebec City. It was interesting to see that him, Mike Sigrist, and John Stern, I believe other people, but I know at least these three for a fact. So apparently Siggy designed this deck, and it's aiming at beating Jeskai Black, Abzan Aggro, Green White Megamorph. So basically the mid-range decks of the format. And I really like how it's doing it. It's kind of powerful that they just keep chaining Ulamogs and Ugins using a Sanctum of Ugin. So when you play Cardless Spell, Current Desmanica 7 or greater, you may sack this and search your library for any colorless creature card. So it also works with Angerback. When you play Angerback for 4, you can crack your Sanctum of Ugin. So it's actually pretty interesting. There's also a 1 of Rune Processor that you can get in the sideboard. And the deck is really, really bad against Mono Red. So they have main deck Jetty of Shoot, Angerback Walker, I assume is one of the reasons as well. Angerback works well with Map the Waste because you can bolster on it. And that's pretty much the only upside, because Map the Waste is just a bad rampant growth here. Sylvan's Crying, again, not spectacular, but it gets your Shrines and Sanctums, so it's kind of important. And you also have the One of Haven to bring back some Ugins and the Dragon Lord Taka. So basically, I'm playing the same 75 as Jake Mondello, except in his profile, he said he would cut one Hedron Archive for a Fort Nissus Pilgrimage, so I did just that. I don't really understand this Blighted Woodland, but I guess it's there because it's free. I'll try it out. And the sideboard, well, these 4 Seismic Rupture for Monored, obviously. Fugs as well. Fugs great at fighting the combo. And I assume it's probably fine against ramp decks too. No, not ramp decks. Mid-range decks. Nissa, I assume, is for control. So is Whisperwood. Rune Processor against anything that can burn you out. Rending Volley against Jeskai. And the Fort Ulamog. I don't really know. Probably mid-range and control matchups. Not entirely sure about that. I guess maybe when Dragon Lord Taka is bad. So, anyways. I'm really excited to try this deck out. It's kind of straightforward decks, strategies that I love. So I'll be joining an 8-man and we'll see how it goes.